The best place to get information about the Cmore Micro panels is here at the dedicated website at cmoremicro.com. In this video, we'll compare the various Cmore Micro panels so you can see the differences and decide which panel is best for your application. We'll be using this side-by-side comparison chart on the website as a guide for this video and hopefully to give you some insight as to what all this means to you. Before getting into that though, let's take a look at this hardware screen. If you go down into one of these panels, you'll see that for each panel, there's a link to a specs page. That link takes you to a page that tells you everything you need to know about the panel in just a few short pages, including features, dimensions, detailed specs, wiring diagrams, PLC connections, supported protocols, cabling, accessories, replacement parts, and even a software overview. So make sure that's your first stop when you have a question about the panel. Pretty much everything you could want to know is right there on that brief specs document. So let's go back to the comparison chart and start walking through it. The Cmore Micro family currently has 8 different models. 6 of these monochrome models, 4 3-inch and 2 6-inch monochrome models, and the 2 color models for a total of 8 models in the family. These 2 monochrome models offer both a regular and high contrast screen. That's why there's 2 of these. But the 3-inch model also offers a non-touch version. So you have the regular contrast, the high contrast, the touch, and the non-touch for 4 total models of the 3-inch panel. While the 3-inch models are 128 by 64 pixels, all of the other 4 and 6-inch models are quarter VGA at 320 by 240, regardless of the physical size of the unit. The 4-inch and the 6-inch panels have the exact same resolution. The 6-inch panels just have bigger pixels. That quarter VGA gives you over 9 times the screen area of a 3-inch panel. For example, if we look at this 3-inch display that's fully populated by a single analog meter like this, so this is our 3-inch display right here, and we convert that to a 4-inch display, you can see the meter that used to take up the entire 3-inch panel only takes up a small portion of a 4-inch or a 6-inch screen. So again, the 4 and the 6-inch panels have over 9 times the screen area of a 3-inch panel, simply because they have a higher resolution. Characters are the same thing. Horizontally across the screen, you can expect 21 or 32 characters, depending upon what mode you're in, on the 3-inch panel, but on the larger panels, you can get up to 53 or 80 characters per line, again, depending upon what mode you're in. We've already mentioned that all of the panels are touch sensitive, but the 3-inch panels also offer a non-touch version, which can save you around 20% on the cost if your budget requires it. All of the panels offer optional keypad bezels except the 4-inch panel. Note that while the chart says there are 2 styles of bezels for each of the panels, except the 4-inch of course, each panel has different styles. For example, the 3-inch panels offer these with 2 different kinds of keypads. One is a numeric keypad, and the other one is an arrow-only keypad. But the 6-inch panel offers a portrait and a landscape version of just the numeric keypad. There is no separate directional arrow keypad for either of the 6-inch panels. All the panels support graphics, both built-in and user-generated, by the way. All panels have a beep, a little audio tone, support built-in fonts and Windows fonts, and support data entry methods of both on-screen pop-up keypads for the touchscreen versions, increment-decrement operators, and on all the panels but the 4-inch that have the keypad bezels, the optional physical keypads that you can plug the panel into. The 3 and a 6-inch monochrome models come with 5 different color LED backlights, and the 4 and a 6-inch color models have 32,768 colors to choose from. These monochrome models come in a high contrast or regular contrast model. The high contrast models really help if you need to view the panel from a larger distance, but they only have these 5 shades of red for the LED backlight color. The regular contrast panels have 5 different backlight colors, which is nice because the different color screens can help the user quickly assess what's going on just by the screen color. We've already mentioned that the color models support 32,768 colors, but we haven't mentioned one other advantage which isn't shown here. The color panels have a much wider viewing angle. The monochrome STNs are good for about 15 degrees off axis. The color panels are good to up to around 70 degrees. Different axes have different viewing angles, of course, so check out the spec sheets for more on that. All of the panels have 5 function keys, or 9 with shift. There's a way you can implement a shift key to give you an extra set of function keys. Along with those function keys, all the panels have 5 user-definable LEDs on those function keys. The smaller panels can be powered directly from compatible PLCs without the need for another power supply. Of course, most of the AutomationDirect PLCs support this feature. To figure out which PLCs support powering the panels and which cables you need to do it, simply go to the specs page for each panel and look it up. Or better yet, go to the connectivity page on this website, scroll down to these links right here, and you can see a connectivity chart for the small 3-inch panels or for the larger 4 and 6-inch panels. Let's look at the 3-inch panels first. Here we can see that a 3-inch panel can be powered directly from a Click PLC serial ports 1 or 2 using this cable and this protocol. The Productivity 3000, same thing. If we use the RS-232 port and this cable, then the 3-inch micrographic panel can be powered directly from a Productivity 3000 PLC without an additional power supply. So this chart shows you exactly what you need to power a panel for every PLC in the AutomationDirect lineup, plus many other industry standard PLCs too. One side note, this chart is for the 3-inch panels. If we click on the link for the bigger panels, right here, you'll see a note at the bottom of the chart, right here. This note is reminding us that for the larger panels, while you can power the panel from a PLC serial port, it's really only intended for programming. This is called low power mode. In this mode, the LCD brightness will be diminished and the alarm tones will be disabled. All of the color panels can be programmed via USB in low power mode. Let's go back to our comparison chart and finish this thing up. All of the panels have the same indoor ratings, all the same agency certifications, and all of the panels support 999 screens, depending upon how much memory you use, of course. Each panel has this much memory. And of course, the programming software for the Cmore Micro family is always free. You can download it right here. One final note, if we go back to the main website and scroll down to the bottom of the page, there's a little ad here for the Cmore panels. These are the Cmore Micro's big brothers. They're available in 6, 8, 10, 12, and 15-inch models, but the key thing to note here is they also have bigger and more advanced features. Things like data logging, Ethernet communications, more colors, audio playback, you can actually play back audio files instead of just beeps, more resolution, and of course, bigger sizes. And you can even view the full-featured models remotely from your desktop PC or a smartphone. So if you need any of those features, be sure to check out the Micro's big brother, the Cmore panels. Well, that should be more than enough to get you started. Remember, everything you need to know about these panels is located here at cmoremicro.com. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.